2021年度绍伊夫数学科学奖颁予杰夫·齐格和尚·米歇尔·比斯姆，表扬他们对现代几何学的贡献。他们的研究改变了其中一个最古老的数学分支。杰夫·齐格喜欢在树林散步，思考几何问题。这里是美国缅因州，杰夫也很喜欢泛舟湖上分析数学问题。
The thing is, Jeff is in the interface between space and calculus. He uses calculus very powerfully in his analysis of space.
同事说，杰夫·齐格的研究将微分方程、微分几何和拓扑等范畴联系起来，有助整合几何学的不同观点。杰夫也独创了一套理解方法。
Jeff is one of his strong points is thoroughly analyzing and trying to understand not only what you appear in the surface, but what's behind it. And this is part of what it means to be a good mathematician, to see what's behind things. And then if you're very thorough and put a lot of work into it, you can make progress.
杰夫在纽约布鲁克林长大，在父亲的熏陶下，杰夫从小就爱上数学。
My father introduced me to math when I was about 7, so he taught me some elementary algebra, and I really liked it. I liked the idea that I knew something that the other kids didn't know. I seemed to be good at it. He would teach me more intermittently, but not systematically, not in any way like he was pushing me.
杰夫曾经为选读数学还是物理学而烦恼。当时他知道数学更适合自己，但尚未放弃物理学，直到在哈佛大学读完第一年的课程。
After the first year in college, I ruled it out. It was clear. And I had a very exciting math course that I took as a freshman with a very inspiring teacher, Shlomo Sternberg. And that also played a big role.
杰夫在普林斯顿大学取得数学博士学位。他说，数学最引人入胜的地方在于数学理论永恒不变。由毕达哥拉斯和欧几里得的时代开始，数学世界始终如一。
Math uniquely builds on itself, right? Because once something is proved, then it's always going to be true. So it can build on itself over millennia.And people in different cultures, and different races, and it doesn't, none of that makes the slightest difference because the theorem doesn't care about who proved it. So, in my view, math is a high level unifying force for mankind.
杰夫喜欢画当年，分享数学生涯的点滴。
Here was for.This is a very close friend and colleague, a real genius, Misha Gromov. So this was for our 60th birthdays. And here I had, at this time, 5 Chinese students from mainland China. See all these guys this year. They made for me, it's a tradition in China. When you get your PhD,You go to your advisor's house, and this says something like great teacher, useful friend, or something along those lines. So this is very traditional.
Kneading down.
杰夫忙于研究几何空间时，妻子雪莉就会做陶瓷。雪莉说，她永远不会看得懂这些数学公式，但很欣赏杰夫一丝不苟的态度。
He spends a lot of time working. He's very serious about it because he is who he is. He thinks about just about every question very thoroughly. So sometimes it doesn't really need a detailed answer. It just needs a yes or no answer. And other times, the way he thinks is enlightening, inspiring.
杰夫和雪莉在高中救生聚会中见面后就坠入爱河，后来成为夫妻。
We met at our 30th high school reunion. So we went to the same high school, but it was a very big high school, so we didn't really know each other. There were about 2,000 people in our graduating class. But 30 years later, we met at our first reunion. Is it clear, or is the math too complicated?
We were in our 40s at the time.
If that helps.
杰夫·齐格在1993年加入纽约大学科朗数学研究所，现在是教授。他之前在普林斯顿大学、密西根大学和纽约州立大学实习分校任职。同时说，杰夫的研究非常原创和进取，当中的数学问题非常困难。
So it takes both great ability and great determination to work on problems like that, and he's demonstrated all of that repeatedly in different directions, in geometry and in high-dimensional geometry, and it in turn has repercussions in other areas of mathematics.
虽然杰夫是理论数学家，但卡佩尔说，他的研究对应用科学和工程学的研究都很有帮助。
Some of the methods that Jeff pioneered in continuous geometry, in geometry of shape and form, have in turn had applications by being extended to discrete geometry, to things like the web and searching on the web. So indirectly, his ideas have influenced things like web search as well. So they're important in ways that could have been anticipated, and also in novel ways that could not have been anticipated. They've had an influence in that kind of broad range of subjects.
杰夫·齐格的代表作是齐格常数，也就是将流形分割成两部分超曲面的最小面积。
The Cheeger constant, for example, this methodology has been used in many places. In theoretical computer science and graph theory, various places in discrete math, and so on. So I'm sure that those applications have downstream impacts on design of devices and algorithms and so on.
对于获得邵逸夫奖，杰夫·齐格一直保持谦逊。
Certainly, it doesn't require genius, although there are mathematical geniuses. So I like to think of it this way. You could think of it by analogy with a sport. So a key point is there are many levels and many ways to make a meaningful contribution.
巴黎有光之城的美誉，这座城市同样是数学之城。上米歇尔·比斯姆和妻子散步，他在过去的50多年解决了一些多年来都没有答案的问题。他的研究拓展了几何学的领域。比斯姆在求学时期展现科学天分，他当初最喜欢物理学。
And everything which was done at the time in modern physics, I was very enthusiastic about this. That, in some sense, I decided to do math instead, because to be a physicist, you need to have a sort of drive to understand the reality as it is. And I'm more understanding reality as I make it. I mean, you know, as I build it for myself.
比斯姆毕业于综合理工学院，在巴黎第六大学取得数学博士学位，从此投身数学研究。
In physics or in other fields like biology or medicine, you need to interest yourself to things which are dictated to you by the facts. When you're a mathematician, you can decide in some sense where the facts are. You can create the facts for yourself. At least you can invent things, connections between various fields, which you decide, you construct them.
比斯姆现在是巴黎萨克雷大学数学系荣休教授，同时说比斯姆在研究中尽显才华。
What he did essentially was to apply probabilistic technique, which he mastered very, very well, to geometric problems and very difficult geometric problems, which need a kind of a tour de force in terms of calculation.
It's the depth of what he is doing. So far as I know, probably since he was young, he has never attacked a problem which was easy. He has worked on problems which are extremely deep, and he has himself introduced techniques which now, apparently in his field, are just normal, even routine, but which he was really the first to use.
俾斯姆目前正在研究与数学真理基本结构相关的难题。
My kind of mathematics is not applied. There is definitely not, I could not say, even though, I mean, it leads to concrete computations, that the computations, the results, are not directly intelligible by anybody willing to apply these to concrete day-to-day problems. Certainly not.